big books right in front of Jeremiah, amen, one of the big books in the Old Testament, the book of Isaiah, the 55th chapter. Chapter. I will begin reading at verse number 6. Please note there were 5 verses before that. And in your own time, it would be very good if you would read it for yourself. Amen. Isaiah 55, verse number 6. Listen real good. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near.
Yeah.
Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him. And to our God, for he will abundantly pardon, he will forgive. For my thoughts are not your thoughts.
They're different.
Praise the Lord. Neither are your ways my ways, said the Lord.
Yes.
For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain cometh down and the snow from heaven, and returneth not there, but watereth the earth, and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower, and bread to the eater. Praise, that sounds good, don't it? So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please. And it shall prosper in the thing whereunto I sent it. Praise the Lord. I want to read some more, but I'll just stop there and trust that you'll read it later. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And I just read all of that so you would know how to read. Amen. Praise the Lord. But all I was, my verse was verse 6. Amen. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. And call ye upon him while he is near. All I want to tell you is to seek him. Amen.
Amen.
Seek the Lord. Seek him. And I want you to note, though, that it says, while he may be found. Now, it doesn't say that specifically right there, but to hear that, while he may be found and while he is near, that sounds like it will come a time when you're going to seek him and can't find him.
That's right.
Praise the Lord. And then I'll tell you something else. You ought to seek him while things are somewhat well. Y'all ain't something. So oftentimes we don't seek him when we got a few nickels. Y'all ain't something. And we got, we can make a good ATM withdrawal. And we got a few so-called friends, and we got a job, and everything seemed to be going well. We have this great tendency to not seek him. Amen. And sometimes we get fooled into thinking that we can make it without him. Amen. But just a reminder that without him, we're nothing. Y'all agree, don't you? I said, without him, we are nothing. And I told you time and time again, that. Without God, we are nothing. But without us, God is still God. Let me make you understand that it's us that need God. It's not God. I'm not petitioning you to come to God because God needs you. I'm petitioning you to come because you need God. And sometimes we can need him so bad we don't even have sense enough. Y'all better get there. We don't even have sense enough to realize that it's him that we need. And all times when we're seeking or should be seeking him, we're seeking everything and everybody but him. I don't care who you know. Now let me tell you something. I know some people. In fact, it's one that's in this church. He just left a few minutes ago, but he can almost fix anything but people.
All right.
He work on cars, houses, trucks, buses, and just whatever it is. Amen. And sometimes we know folk like that who seemingly can do a little bit of everything. Y'all ain't saying that. But when the truth really is told, there's nobody that can do everything except God. Y'all ain't saying that. And then not only that, it doesn't matter how much stuff a person can do. God can position them to where they can't do nothing. And so when we put our confidence in man instead of putting it in God, when we began to trust man based on what we done seen them do, you know my mechanic, he can fix anything. Y'all ain't saying that. I got somebody who can do this and can do that. And we, after a while, we began to put the trust in them and not in God. And occasionally God have to move them. Y'all ain't saying that. Sometimes temporarily, sometimes permanently, but God will occasionally. I'm going too fast. Sometimes God have to move them just so that we can seek him. Amen. Sometimes we get so caught up, we get such good help from people. You know what I'm talking about. We get folk where we can rely on them. They solid. We can trust them. They never let me down. You know, sometimes God have to fix it where they have to let you down so that you can realize that it's him you need. And some folk, you can call them to do, you know, you got issues, y'all ain't saying that. If your car threw up and your sink stopped up, y'all ain't saying that. A lot of times you gotta call two different people. Y'all better get this. But you know, with God, it don't matter what's going on. You could be jacked up on every side. Y'all better, you understand. And you can have problems in the house, out the house, on the job, off the job. You can have problems all around, and God can solve it. That ought to be good news. Amen. That ought to be good news. But let me just tell you something. The fact that he can do it don't mean that he's going automatically.
That's right.
Praise the Lord. Amen. I've known folk who have asked other folk to do stuff that I knew I could have done. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And I ain't going to lie, sometimes I'm glad you asked them. Amen. And you just insist on trusting in Bobo instead of God. Y'all ain't saying that. And you just insist in trusting in Keisha them instead of God. Y'all better get that. After a while, you're going to come to find out that without God, you're not going to make it. Amen. And I like to say this because if ever that was a time that we needed God, it's right now. I'm seeing stuff and hearing stuff that I never thought I would see or hear. Y'all hear me? And it makes me know of a surety that we need God. I'm seeing believers inside the house of God. You know, I've been trying to get started working on a book about grieving and a funeral for black people. Amen. And I mean, it would work for white people, but we do some stuff different. And ain't no book gonna change that. Praise the Lord. But I'm finding so many people who are just stuck in grief mode. And I'm not desensitized. I'm not to the point to where I don't recognize that someone has left or that someone is gone. But the we need to understand that death is God's promise. Death is our only way to get back to God. Y'all ain't saying that. And whether we like it or not, whether it hurts us or not, all of us one day gonna have to die. Y'all ain't saying that. And don't you die because because somebody else died, you still ought to try to live. You ought to still seek God so that God can heal your heart. Y'all know what I'm saying? So that God can heal you. He's able to fill every void. You hear what I said? Every void. God's able to feel, but we got to seek him. You know, I was talking to my friend this morning about that, and I find that when our loved ones pass away, I'm going to tell you why sometimes we can't get closure, and I'm going to get to my text, but sometimes when our loved ones pass away, I've heard people say so many times, well, Pastor, we did want the service to be a little short and sweet service. We don't want to burden the family. We just want a little short and sweet. In other words, don't get up there trying to preach all day. I know what that means. I graduated high school. I know what that means. Don't get up here trying to preach all day. You understand? And not only that, we come to the service, which is designed to help us get closure. And in that service, a lot of times we're trying to show how strong we are. Y'all understand that? At the time when we most are expected and allowed without judgment to be as weak as we can. He says, in our weakness, he is made strong. You don't get to see how strong God is by trying to show God how strong you are. But when you submit yourself and humble yourself and let God break you, y'all understand? Let him break you. So then we come in and sing, and we try to be strong enough to shout, and soon as the preacher stand up to give words of encouragement.
Amen. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus. We know that's what it says on this program, words of encouragement. This water got leaking. And when the preacher stands up to give words of encouragement, oh, it hit us hard then. They be running outside six at a time.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, sir.
So now you wanted this short and sweet. And you skipped out on the words of encouragement. And as soon as you eat them green beans and... Thank you, baby. Yes, sir. When you get to eat those green beans and get back to the house and come to knees, all of a sudden the devil swoops in.
All right.
Yes, sir.
The opportunity you had to get questions answered. We forfeit that. You know, you can't sing your way out of some stuff. You got to hear what God's word is. God give you an opportunity to understand what he just did, and we forfeit that by running out. We want this service to be short and sweet. It's all about the dead person, but we want the service to be short and sweet. What you need is shortness. How many days folks come over there drinking and smoking with you? You need this shortness. Days. You sit around talking and moping. Y'all ain't saying that.
Come on, preach.
Preach. Y'all ain't saying that.
Come on, preach.
Because that ain't going to give you no closure. That's not going to heal you. If that would heal us, some of us would be like two people. You know, we'd be so whole if we had extra. If that could heal us.
Yes, sir.
God speaks to us, and he wants us simply to seek him.
Yes. Hallelujah. Yes.
Did you hear what? Just seek him.
Amen.
We miss these opportunities, even when we come to the house of God. The place that was dedicated, where Solomon prayed, and understanding that the day is coming. I already know that these people going to forsake you. They're going to see him and they're going to walk contrary to your ways. But God, if they come back to this place, y'all are not understanding what this building is about. If they come back to this place, he said that if you done got angry with them and you done shut up heaven, y'all ain't said that it don't rain no more. If you just got so angry with them, if these people, he says, which are called by your name, if they humble themselves, would you, if they turn come in this dedicated place, then God, would you hear from heaven? They would turn from their wicked ways and seek your face. And God answered with a resounding yes. If my people, would you call by my name? But humble themselves. Turn from their wicked ways. And seek my face. Then will I hear them from up in heaven. And I will forgive their sins. And I will heal the land. This is a contingency promise that God has made for us. And this says that it doesn't matter what happened last year. It doesn't matter what happened last month. It doesn't matter what happened last week. It doesn't matter what happened last night. Y'all hear me? It doesn't matter how far you have gone. God is just a call away. But you got to seek him for yourself. You got to have faith enough to believe that there really is a God. And not only that there's a God, but he's got all power. For the scripture says, without faith, it's impossible to please God.
Thank you, Lord.
Because they that would come to him, got to faith, believe that he exists. And that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek after him. You don't skip over that diligently seek after him. Diligently seeking don't mean dropping by church here now and then. I ain't talking about you, but diligently. Diligently don't mean just when it got bad for me. You have to consistently seek him. And what that means is if you look on the left and can't find him, look to the right. If you look in the front and you can't find him, you ought to turn around and look in the back. Make sure that he understands that you understand that I need you. This is a good God we got. And some of us, we say we're seeking God.
All right.
And we doing like spoiled children who spoil the mood. Y'all ain't saying that.
All right.
When you're playing hide and go seek. They can't find you. They just quit looking and go in the house and eat. Y'all ain't saying that. If he don't answer me today, I'm going to still seek him. Because he not hiding from me. But sometimes problems and circumstances would cause us to not be able to see him. So when we're seeking him, don't think he's trying to make himself not be available to you. if you guys looking at the problems,
Amen.
It's far more difficult to see the Lord.
Yeah.
If you're just concerned with what troubles you, and you're not seeking after Him, you gotta understand that you won't be able to find Him. Now I want to say, notice, before you turn me out, that God is real.
Yeah.
And He is alive.
Yes, He is.
And just because you can't see Him does not mean that He's not there.
All right. Right.
If I haven't seen the Lord with my eyes,
Come on,
I have seen the works of God.
Yeah.
I've never seen Him with my eyes. But surely I have seen what He has done.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I've seen how He put the Son where it belongs.
Uh-huh.
And I've never heard of the Son falling to the ground. Y'all know what
I'm saying?
He put His world in its place.
Yeah.
And we used to say, they don't sing it no more, I reckon, but when I was a little boy, they used to sing a song even in school that said, He got the whole world.
Yeah.
In His hand.
Yeah.
They didn't say He got the little bitty babies.
Yeah.
In His hand.
All right.
And that, to me, is good news, because now I don't have to do the worrying. I don't have to do the problem solving. I don't have to do the fixing. All I got to do is seek Him.
Yeah.
You know, and turn it over to Him.
All right.
And know that He's able to fix it.
Yeah,
right. Isaiah's cry to Israel. Yeah. He said, come everyone that is thirsty. He said, come ye to the waters. And He even said, he didn't have no money. Come ye and buy.
Come on, preacher.
That can be confusing. To say he didn't have no money. Come ye and buy. Dealers ain't never said that. Y'all ain't saying that.
All right.
He didn't have no money. Come ye and buy.
All right.
And eat. Yeah, come buy wine and milk without money and without price.
Yeah.
I keep telling you, we got a good God.
Uh-huh.
He said, why do you spend money for that which is not bread, for that which is not real, and your labor for that which don't satisfy you? Says, listen diligently to me and eat that which is good, and let your soul delight itself in fatness. You know the scripture says, delight yourself in the Lord. And He'll give you the desires of your heart. In fact, Matthew 6 and 33 says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all of His righteousness. And whatever you need will be added to you. So then that says, instead of seeking stuff and things, just seek the Lord. For He's able to deliver you and rescue you. Some of us have got on this quest. You say, I'm going job hunting. And if you're jobless and you want a job hunting, the goal is to hunt until you find a job. You don't go one place and they say no and you go back home. Because you're hunting or seeking for a job. As you seek the Lord, just know that none of us have been so righteous. so good until God owes us to come running to us. Y'all answer. You know how you are when somebody hadn't done what you wanted them to do. When somebody that took you for granted.
Yes.
When somebody didn't come when you called them. And then they call you. Y'all ain't saying that. And you look at the call out. You look at the call ID and tell me, where was he last week? I'm gonna call him, but I ain't finna talk now. Y'all better get this. Some of y'all did that, didn't they? They didn't come right. They wasn't calling when they didn't need nothing. They wasn't calling. They wasn't answering when I called. None of us have been so faithful to God. And God ought to just come running on the first call. And then God wants us to have faith. In order to have faith, or in order to demonstrate to God that we have faith, that means to ask God to do something. Ask God for something and trust that God is going to do it. Not because he owe it to you, but trust it because he said we could ask it, and we ask and believe that we can ask anything in his name. Y'all ain't saying that. He says, if my word, this for believers, this ain't for everybody, that's why it ain't working for some folks. This is for believers. He said, if my word abide in you and you abide in me, then you can ask what you will. To help somebody make you understand why it don't work, because you got these naming and claiming fools around here trying to make folks think that you can make God do something. You can't make God do nothing. He says, if my word abide in you, and you abide in me, then and only then, you can ask what you will, and my Father will give it to you. But if God just gave it to you as soon as you asked, then faith would never be involved. Because sometimes we get under pressure. And sometimes the deadline is rapidly approaching. And God still haven't done what we asked him to do. And I want you to know God is not bound by deadlines like you and I are. He's not bound by this or that. A few months ago, whose husband had just got a job, and she said, well, at first, they said they gave the job to somebody else. But that person, some kind of way, had to pass up the job. So the same folk who called and said, we hired somebody else, y'all ain't saying that, have to call back and say, well, that didn't work out. You still want the job. So God is not bound by deadline. He can work in his own time. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
He won't call. They tell you it got to be done. That's what Mary and Martha thought when they told Jesus, if you have a baby, if you have a cane when we call you, our brother wouldn't die. Well, that's a true statement, but what Jesus is saying, it gets better than that. I didn't come when you called me, and he did die, but I'm about to get him up. Y'all better go get him. You got to operate on the same thing that we operate on.
All right.
Just because he didn't do something when you thought he ought to have done it, doesn't mean that he can't still do it. You ought to hope against hope. Not hope because it looks good, but hope because it looks bad. And I want to tell you, no matter how bad your circumstances look, the Lord looks better. No matter how dire it is, we got a God who is able to do everything but fail. And we are willing to come to church. churches. That is our ability to seek the Lord.
Yeah.
And sometimes inquiry hurts us. Instead of trying to seek the best song, y'all ain't saying that. Instead of trying to seek out the best voices, we ought to just come in and seek the Lord. For you rehearsing right and practice make perfect. Y'all ain't saying that. If you want to feel Him on Sunday, you ought to try to feel Him in choir rehearsing. Y'all ain't saying that. Instead of coming in acting like we're not in the house of God, instead of coming in fussing and arguing and picking over a few nickels or over who gonna sing, y'all ain't saying everybody can sing on every song. Everybody can participate.
Yes, sir.
Some folk don't even realize we worship Him until time comes for their song. And I know where you get it from. Some of those preachers are like that. Sitting in the office smoking and joking till time for them to come out. And then come out, come on, praise the Lord. That's what we were doing while you were back there doing whatever you were doing. Y'all ain't saying that. Why can't we start praising without the time to cry? Trouble me.
Yeah.
You see, preachers who can't never stand up and remember what they doing.
Amen.
You never see folk don't matter in the service move them unless they the one did it.
Yes.
It's one thing to have the ability to make other folks shout. Y'all ain't saying that. But when can't nobody make you shout, they ain't wrong with you. There's something wrong with you. Get all dignified. As soon as somebody dies, you want to call a whole bunch of them to come in here and get the blackest suit they can find. Y'all ain't saying that. And sat there looking like they dead. Yeah, what's up? Uh-oh, uh-oh. Some of these folks can't.
Yeah.
I come expecting you to encourage me and lift me up and let me know that it's going to be all right and explain to me what God tells me. And you and them looking like you don't even know where you
at.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. That's right.
Thank you, Lord.
That's right.
That's it. Did we come in and seek God?
Thank you, God.
Well, I know it said, while He may be found. Otherwise, it didn't say you had to do it between 6 and 7. Y'all ain't saying that. And it didn't say you had to do it a certain time of the day.
All right.
Then I said you can seek Him only on certain days.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Simply says seek the Lord while He may be found.
Uh-huh.
Call upon Him while He is near.
Uh-huh.
And I marvel at some folk. We come in with all kind of problems. And all start moving on the same pew you said no.
Amen.
And folks shut their eyes shut. Folks shouting all around you.
Amen.
And why they shouting, you watching them. Y'all ain't sorry. Like you gonna catch it or something. Like something gonna hurt you. Y'all better get this. So if you're that close to me.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna waste this moment trying to figure out what you're doing. I'm not gonna waste this moment trying to decipher who real and who fake. But seek Him while He can be found. And call on Him while He is near. And you know, it's important because a lot of folk are falling by the wayside. Getting caught up with what other folk are saying and getting caught up with what the devil is trying to do. For I told you, John 10:10, y'all ain't sleep, is it? John 10:10 said, for the thief come. Just to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But Jesus said, I have come.
Yes.
that you might have life, and that you might have it more abundance.
All right.
And I see every day clearly that what the devil came to do, he's doing exactly that. And whatever you do, don't let him steal your faith. For if he can steal your faith, y'all ain't saying that, then he can steal your joy. And if he can steal your joy, he can steal your peace. For Jesus told Peter, say unto Simon, the devil desire to have you. That he might sift you as wheat. Hear what he said, but I have prayed for you. And faithfully said, the faith I have in praying for you, I know you're going to be all right. He said, so when you are confronted, then you need to strengthen your brother. And you got to understand that the devil's objective is to destroy all of us. And he wants to get you to a point or to a place to where you don't believe God will hear you and answer your prayer. He wants to discredit you and discredit God. Y'all ain't saying that. And want you to believe that it's all hopeless. He wants you to believe that it's all helpless. That there's no cause, no case, no reason. And you know, I'm going to tell you something. I see that some confusion coming. I was in a service the other night, and the man was preaching, and the man said he's getting tired of hearing people say that God is in control. And he said God is not in control of the earth. The devil's in control of the earth. Now, I do it to his credit. I understand what he's trying to say. But this would be very confusing to me if it wasn't established in me who God is. Because that would indicate that we would need to pray to the devil instead of God. Y'all understand that? Now, the devil has some power, but God has all power. And as somebody just told me, the devil had to get permission to attack Job. Y'all understand that? So if you are a child of God, I don't care what nobody said, God is in control of your life. God is in control, and God is able.
Amen.
Thank you,
Lord.
So when folk make statements like that, it comes because he tied it to death. He was saying people get upset when people die, and he was saying that, you know, people start saying God is in control, and if God was in control, then why did these people die? That reaffirms the fact that God is in control, because it was God who said it is appointed to man to die once, and after death comes the judgment. It was God who said it. God is the only giver and taker of life.
Yes.
He went to talking about who the devil killed. The devil ain't never killed nobody. Did you hear what I said? He didn't kill Jesus. The devil ain't never killed nobody. He don't have it in his power to kill nobody. Life and death is in the hand of God and God only.
Hey. Yeah. All right.
Amen.
Now, why are we seeking? Because if we get to know him, then we understand what he's doing.
Amen.
You understand that? If you got friends and acquaintances, sometimes they can do something that to everybody else looked like the stupidest thing somebody could have ever done. But because you know them, you know exactly why they did it.
Yeah. That's right.
Have you ever heard somebody talking about one of your friends talking about he should have never, he did this, she did that, and you sitting there looking at him like, you just don't know. Have you ever heard somebody say, I wonder why they would do that? When you're friends with somebody, you don't have to wonder why they do stuff. Even if it don't necessarily make sense to you, you can understand them to know why they do and what they do. You got to get to know God to understand God's business. You got to get to know him for this. Make sense out of what God does.
Yes.
Some stuff simply don't, you can't reconcile. But the good thing is, the scripture said we'll understand it better. By and by. Hallelujah. He says, first, you know, in terms of uncertainties, time of bereavement, in times of any loss, you ought to seek the Lord.
Amen.
I didn't say seek church, but seek God.
Amen.
Part of the problem that we have with seeking God, we can't quit looking at people. Y'all ain't saying there are so many folk, you ask them about God, ask them about coming to church, and first thing they tell you, well, I went to this church and them people wasn't right. Hey, y'all know I'm stupid. I just always want to ask them, how right were you? I went in there from that church, come see me. Let me ask you, how many people did you go see at God's will? You were a member, right? Huh? You can't be the church and turn around and judge the church. Y'all understand that? And judge it differently than how you judge yourself.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
I got a member sometimes be talking to me and they always see y'all in them. You know what I'm talking about? Like, y'all got to go over to such and such church next Sunday. Y'all got anniversary coming up. You understand once you come in and you join, it ain't y'all no more, it's us and we. I mean, it's like you're trying to pass up two or three different churches in the same building. You always say, you got some Sunday folk, you got some every other Sunday folk, and then you got some folk. But I believe no matter what your lot is, that God has been just as good to each and every one of us. Because He still allowed you to have breath in your body. Whatever you lost, you can get it back. Y'all ain't saying that. As long as there's breath in your body, you can get it back. And we allow the devil to steal our joy. We allow the devil to steal our praise. And we come in church and, well, I would go to church, but they just ain't right. Church people just ain't right.
Amen.
Now, I'm going to tell you why church people, y'all probably can cut that off already. And I'm going to tell you why it seems like church people ain't right. Because before people become church people,
Amen.
They be people.
Amen. That's right.
Before people become church people, they simply be people.
Yeah.
And then after people become church people, they still be people.
Amen. Yes, sir.
All right.
You get all gonna get
it? Yeah, we got it.
So some folk are missing God. Simply because they're looking at people. You're not going to see God through people. You got to look around people. You got to look beyond people. You got to look under people and over people in order to see God.
Amen.
Talk about you ain't going to church no more because of something happened to you in 1978. You ought not even remember what that was. Go out to eat. You know how them folk be when you get your income tax and 2 minutes go at the restaurant. And then you get in there and don't like the food and don't like the service. How many of y'all just say, I ain't eating no more? Just forget it. You know I ain't say it. But only be God get that one chance.
Right.
churches everywhere. You know, if all these churches were the same, it would just be one church. Y'all ain't saying that. You haven't tried all of them. You got to seek God. You better seek him some kind of way. If you don't have the means and the ability, folks, now you got this new thing. I'm not religious, but I'm spiritual.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, everybody's spiritual because we all are a spirit. But you got to have the right spirit. Y'all ain't saying that. We all are spiritual because we're spiritual beings. We are spirits. But it's not enough to say I'm spiritual, because when God comes back and he comes and asks you, he's going to say, give an account of yourself.
Amen.
Told y'all the other day, somebody told me that Oprah Winfrey says 1,000 ways to get to God. I know you're rich, my woman, but you don't bump your head.
Amen.
They should have put them back where they had on color purple for saying something like that. Ain't no thousand ways to get to God. Jesus said, I am the way, truth, and the life. Can no man come to the Father except he come by me. And you can't come by him except you seek him. And sometimes things can get so hard. It can get, the nights can be so dark. Get dark as 1,000 midnights. Yeah. But you gotta know that God is alive.
Yeah.
And somebody said, I used to sing a song, say he's been listening all night long.
Yeah.
Just to hear you. Some sinner pray.
Yeah. All right.
Been listening all night long.
Oh, yeah.
To hear somebody say,
uh-huh,
I'm sick and tired of hearing singing this.
Yeah.
All right. His ear is me now this way.
Yeah.
Just to hear somebody,
uh-huh,
call on his name.
Yeah.
Oh Lord, the God we serve, if you call him, he'll hear and answer prayer. He'll open doors that have been closed in your face. Tell us the power through you, and you're thinking that God doesn't care. Come on. for him.
Yes.
If we all live together, y'all ain't sad now. I need somebody to run what we need. If we all come here, I know the truth. on Sunday morning that we had all come in to see the Lord. I wish somebody and some of the people called to worship, somebody's hand would already be in the air. It ought to come in with uplifted heart. I don't want to go takes too long. The air conditioner on, it ain't hot. You ain't sitting in the sun like you was at Bobo Ball game. You ain't sitting in the rain like you was while Jesus was still here.
Do something I do too.
Amen.
But
I pray it's all the business is to seek him. Don't seek positions, don't seek titles, don't seek attention, don't seek nothing. God! Praise the Lord.
Glory, glory.
I know that's enough for a fifth Sunday. I hope y'all come back next fifth Sunday too. But y'all got me. And I just want some folk to seek him consistently. Don't just seek him to get the blessing. Now I'm going to tell you that, as the Bible said. The Lord cured and healed. Simply by telling them to go show yourselves to the priest. That was the step you were supposed to take after you were cleansed. Go show yourself to the priest, and the priest's job was to declare you as clean. And then your job was to give the priest an offering. And when the lepers came to Jesus, he done skipped all the steps and put them to. And the Bible said, on their way. Because it took some faith. It took some Jesus to go show yourself to the priest. What the priest going to tell me when I'm full of that? But the Bible said, on their way, they looked and saw that they were healed. They didn't need no priest to tell them they were healed at that point. You ain't no somebody to tell you got it going on. If you got it going on, you don't need nobody to tell you. Much as we stay in the mirror, y'all ain't saying that. If we got it going, we got it going on. Ain't nobody got to tell us. Let folk fool us from self-esteem. Then you gonna esteem yourself. Make yourself feel good. Pull yourself out the rut. You the one put you in the rut. How you gonna pull you out the rut?
Amen.
That's what a rut is. Something you can't get out of. That was somebody help you. The ten lepers. The Bible said on their way. Looked at themselves. And saw that they were clean. And one of them understood. That the priest's job was to declare them clean. But he knew that it was Jesus who made them clean. Y'all ain't saying that. And we're trying to get to the folk who can make the declaration instead of getting the one who able to be clean. And we trying to get the man instead of looking for God who's able to make the folk. Came back, the Bible said, when he saw it, tell the one leper came back to tell Jesus, thank you. Some of us will seek him until we get that blessing. It was 10, but only one came back. You hear me? It was 10. Only one came back. It was 10 of them.
Yes.
And only one came back to say thank you. And the Bible said he was a foreigner. He was a Samaritan. He was not a Jew.
Yes.
But he came back to show appreciation. Why? Because those Jews thought they were entitled. They acted like Jesus owed it to them. Like some of us, we think God owed it to us to wake us up this morning. God ain't under contract with none of us. He could have let us sleep on. After all, he did let some people sleep on. You didn't know just because you woke up, everybody didn't wake up. Through Minister Thomas, would you come and the blood will never lose its power.
Amen.
I told my wife yesterday, this Friday I invite her while I petition, man. Praise the Lord. I can't say, listen. No. Second service dog, thank you, my service dog. And last night I was at the house singing and the dog came over and started licking me like, it's gonna be all right. If you hear them.
Amen.
Amen.
If you don't know him.
The love.